Hey guys, welcome back to my channel Scheme Tutorials Hub. In this video, I will show you how to set up VS Code so that we can compile and run MPI based on C, which is basically used for parallel programming. But before going to the video, if you are new on this channel, then hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for the latest updates. At first, we have to download and install VS Code and set up MinGW compiler in order to execute C and C++ programs within VS Code. We have already made a video on how to set up VS Code for executing C and C++ programs. I will put the link of that video in the description box as well as in the pinned comment. At first, watch that video and complete the VS Code setup and then continue watching this video. Open any browser and search for MPI download on Google. Click on the first link of Microsoft. Then come down to the download section and click on download. We have to download both these files, so I am selecting both the files and click on next. So here you can see both the files have been downloaded. Now we have to install both the files one by one. First, I will install the MS-MPI setup.exe file. After clicking on the icon, one dialog box will appear where we have to click on yes. Then click on next. And then accept the license agreement and click on next. Now here you can keep the default installation path, but I am going to change it because when I tried to install in the default path, I got an error, which I will share in the later part of the video. After changing the path, click on OK and click next. Then click on install. The installation will take some time. After the installation is complete, click on finish. Now I am going to install the other file, that is msmpi.sdk.msi. Click on run, then click next, accept the terms and click on next. Here again, I am going to change the path for the same reason. After changing the path, click on OK and click next. Then click on install. In between, one dialog box will appear where you have to click on yes. After the installation is complete, click on finish. So, both the installation has been done. It's time to set up the VS Code. But before going to VS Code, open the command prompt and type set MS-MPI and press enter. These are the 5 environment variables that has been already set. Keep this tab open because we will need these later. Here comes the final part of the setup. I have written a very basic MPI program. I am coming to the program later, but let's focus on the line number 2. Here I have used #include mpi.h. mpi.h is the header file which contains the functions of MPI. But you can see one error is showing. If I move the cursor over this line, you can see the error message says #include errors detected, which means VS Code is not identifying mpi.h as a valid header file. Now click on quick fix and then click edit include path setting. A new tab will open of C++ configuration. Scroll down until you find include path. Here we have to add the environment variable of the include folder. As shown above, the format is $ and then within curly braces we have to add the workspace folder. From the command prompt, I will copy the environment variable name and paste it here. Then close the C++ configuration tab. Here you can see the error is gone. That is, VS Code is identifying mpi.h as a valid header file. Click on the terminal menu and select the last option, that is configure default build task, and then click on the build active file option. A new file will be generated, that is tasks.json. In the tasks.json file, come to the ARGS part. Here we have to add three things. Come to line number 11, where it is written $file, and press enter. Then type -I within double quotes and put a comma and press enter. Then within double quotes type $, then within curly braces copy paste the environment variable of the include folder from the command prompt and put a comma at the end and press enter. Then type -L within double quotes and put a comma and press enter. In the next line, open the double quotes, type $, and then within curly braces, copy paste the environment variable of the lib folder. You can see there are two environment variables of lib folder. You can choose either of them depending on your machine. If your machine is 32-bit, then choose the second last one. And if your machine is 64-bit, then choose the last one. Then put a comma at the end and press enter. In the next line, type -LMS-MPI within double quotes and put a comma. Then save this file and close the tab. Now go to the terminal menu and select run build task. Here you can see one error is showing. You can see I have used a function strcpy, but I have missed the header file string.h, which is needed for it. So I will add the line #include string.h. I will again go to the terminal menu and select run build task. This time the build is successful. One warning is showing, though it is not an error, it is just saying that as I have not given any return type of the main function, it is automatically converted to integer return type. Now coming to the program, what the program will do is that the processors with rank greater than 0 will send a message "Hello participants," and the rank 0 processor will receive the messages and print it. If you remember, when we set up the VS Code for C++ program, we configured it such a way that when we click on the run button, it will do both compile and execute in a single step. But in this program, we have command line arguments, so we have to execute manually with command line arguments. Now we have to go to the terminal menu and select new terminal. In the terminal, we have to type mpi.exec --n the number of processors. Here I am giving 4, again space, and type the file name without any extension. So here is the output. You can see we have received the message "Hello participants" from the three processors, that is 1, 2 and 3. That is how you can set up VS Code to compile and execute MPI programs based on C. Now let's talk about the error which I mentioned at the starting of the video. So when I installed the setups in the default locations, these errors were showing. So you can see the compiler is not able to identify the file path
because it has divided the file path after the spaces. To avoid this error, install the setups in a different location and make sure that the folder names don't have spaces. Also try to avoid long names.
So I have shown you the process how to set up VS Code to compile and run MPI programs based on C. If you have any doubt, then tell me in the comments. If you find this video helpful, then like and share the video and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you.